Hello everybody. It is now day 12 of the 5th eruption from the Svartsengi system on the Reykjanes peninsula in Iceland and is showing no signs of slowing down. Subsidence, which had been ongoing the first 5 days of the eruption, has stopped with GPS data suggesting uplift could be resuming. On June 8th, a sudden outburst of lava occurred which flowed over Grindavík's main road, as well as creeping over the barriers north of the power plant. Why did that happen? What are the newest numbers? Well, let's check out the details. Beginning with the lava outburst. For the last couple of days, lava has been pooling up in this area, which is at the western roots of Mount Sýlingarfell. On June 8th, the lava pool had filled up to the point where the blockage containing it burst, which sent a lot of lava downslope all at once. So, this did not occur due to increased activity from the erupting crater. This lava flow was quite voluminous and went far, flowing over Grindavík's main road, stopping 700 meters away from the main hot water pipe for the Reykjanes Peninsula. Lava also began flowing over the barriers in this area, but only in little amounts. This outburst has now stopped, so everything's fine, right? Well, not exactly. The lava pool responsible for this outburst has already began filling up, which means a repeat of this event is eventual. For this reason, our experts think the lava will eventually reach the hot water pipe if nothing is done to prevent it. This, along with the fact lava is flowing over the barriers in one area, is the reason upgrades to the barriers are being planned. Hopefully, they'll have enough time to implement them. On to the newest numbers. This troublesome lava flow has added a lot to the area compared to recently, with the current outline looking something like this. It is likely just shy of 9 square kilometers, as, during the last detailed estimate from our experts on June 3rd, it was at 8.6 square kilometers. The volume on that same date, June 3rd, was estimated to be at 36 million cubic meters, which is considerably lower than the 44 million cubic meters I estimated it to be at in my last video on June 2nd. If we estimate the average lava output since June 3rd to have been 6 cubic meters per second, the total volume should be around 39 million cubic meters today on June 9th. This does not affect the eruption's ranking, as it still sits comfortably in second place amongst the 8 eruptions that have occurred since 2021. The current output is most likely only around 4 cubic meters per second, which is similar to what the previous eruption maintained for most of its lifetime. Since the output levels have dropped down to these lower levels, we're expecting GPS data to show uplift again, or at least flat readings. That is exactly what we're seeing. Although it might be too early to say, it looks like uplift has resumed, which would mean the influx of magma into the chamber is greater than the current output of the eruption. This means it's likely that the influx is somewhere in the 4 to 5 cubic meter per second range. So, this eruption has, without a doubt, struck the same balancing point as its predecessor, but it's been really stable in the last 10 days, according to the tremor charts. This leaves the door wide open for a long eruption. I just want to thank everyone who made it here. Definitely leave any speculations and questions in the comments. It's always fun to read them. Other than that, I just hope you enjoyed. Hope to see most of you in the next video, and thanks for watching.